If you like my dad's videos, please subscribe to QA Insights channel.
Welcome to Learn JMeter series. In this season 4, episode 7, we are going to see about JSR 2 to 3 variables. In JSR 2 to 3 sampler, you can leverage the built-in variables such as CTX, VARS, props, etc. There are totally 11 types of variables you could use in the sampler. But in this video, we are going to cover only the first three, CTX, VARS, and props. CTX stands for context, which means JMeter context. It's a context for a thread. All the classes and methods are available in this link. Basically, it will help you to interact with the JMeter context using the CTX statement. In the demo, we are going to see more classes and methods with respect to CTX. Now we shall see the next one, VARS, or variables. If you want to interact with the variables of a JMeter or your user-defined variables, then VARS is the keyword. You can use the get method to read the variable value, or if you want to update the variable value, you can use the set. Similarly, you can use get object and put object method also in the VARS. Next, we are going to see about props, which stands for properties. If you want to read or update some of the JMeter property, then you can use get or put, and also get property or put property. You can also interact with your operating system variables using system.getProperty. In the demo, we are going to see those small snippets. Now let us go to the simple JMeter test plan, where we are going to see the sample snippets about CTX, VARS, and props. So in the left side, we have the simple JMeter test plan. We have three JSR 2 to 3 samplers. One is for CTX, second one is for VARS, and third one is for props. If you click on CTX, you can see the methods for the context. For example, if you want to read the engine name, you can use the get engine method. Similarly, if you want to read the thread details, you can use the thread, get thread group, get thread number. And if you want to read all the properties of JMeter, you can use get properties. And also, if you want to get the specific property value, you can use get properties dot get property. And if you want to read the variables, you can use the get variables. So now let me run this particular snippet. So on the right side, you can see the output. So as you see, it is displaying the engine name, thread details, thread group, thread number, and all the properties, and the specific JMeter version, and the p underscore username variables value. So this p underscore username has been defined in the test plan level. You can see p underscore username is the admin. So this is how the context will work. More details you can find in the link, which is in the description. Now let me disable this and enable the VARS keyword. So this VARS will help you to interact with the variables, and you can update the variable values using the vars.put. So here we are reading the variable name from the JMeter test plan, and we are updating the value, and we are removing it, and again we are getting the value, so it should print the value null. Similarly, you can use the put object to write into some variable name, and you can use the get object. So now if I run this particular snippet, you can see the admin and the new username, my new username, and after removing it, it is displaying as null, and the new value ROM and 35. So this is how this get and put, get object and put object will work in JSR 2 to 3. This will be very, very helpful if you are writing the custom coding in JSR 2 to 3. Now let me disable this and enable the props. If you want to interact with properties, you can use the props.get or props.put. If you want to interact with the system properties, you can use the system.getProperty. And if you want to update something, you can use the props.put. So these are the sample snippets. If I run this, you can see the output, the timestamp, and the remote host name, the address, and the operating system, and again the remote host. So I'm not updating my remote host, but if you want to update, it will just overwrite the value. So that's the guess of my side. If you have any questions, please let me know. And feel free to join my QA Insights community. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.
If you like my dad's videos, please subscribe to QA Insights channel.